Today we are going to show you our motor control trainer. Order code is 52060. Here are four types of motor. This is unipolar stepper motor, this is bipolar stepper motor, this is servo motor and this is DC motor. This is the input drive and this is the output drive. This is the LCD, 7 segment LCD display. This is RS-230 port for interfacing with computer. And this is the microcontroller portion. With the help of this we can operate the motor. With this trainer, the manual and the patch parts are included, and this is a DC adapter. Connect this like this and the motor will be on. This adapter is also provided with the trainer kit. Our first experiment is unipolar motor operating principle in discrete mode. For this we will connect DCM to DIR, CKE to S in, that is step input, S1 to one phase and S2 to half step. Now we will connect the driver output to motor input. So connect A1 with 1. This is the driver output and this is the motor input. We will connect this . Now connect the adapter with the trainer kit. We can see the unipolar stepper motor is running. So this is the direction switch, this one. With the help of this switch we can select the direction, that is motor will run in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction. Right now it is running in clockwise direction and you can select it to CCW and it will move in anti-clockwise direction. Also with the help of this knob you can select the speed of the motor. Also with the help of this switch we can select the speed of this motor. With the help of this switch we can select the mode. This is the one phase, sorry, this is the half step and this is the one phase. Our next experiment is unipolar motor operating principle in MCU51 mode. That is, we will use this microcontroller to control the motor. So first connect I1 to DIR, I2 to step input, I4 to one phase and I3 to half step. Now after that we will connect the driver output to motor input. So connect this . Now turn on the key and we can see in the LCD it is showing motor control, select the motor. So we will select unipolar as we have done interfacing with the unipolar stepper motor. So select this. After that it will show select mode. So select MCU51 and press enter. After mode selection we need to select user selection mode, either step or run. So I am selecting step. Now after that press enter. Now we need to select motor operating modes, that is half, pull and wave. So with the help of this key we are selecting half. Now press enter and now we need to select the direction. So I am selecting clockwise. After that press enter. And now we need to select the up button to steps counting. We can see the counting is started, press enter, and we can also see the motor is started rotating clockwise at 90 degrees. Now if we select run, then the mode will automatically step count. So for this reset, now unip select. Now select the motor unipolar. After that select the mode, press enter. After mode selection, we will select the user selection mode, that is either step or run. Now press run. After that press enter, and there is operator manual. Now we need to select half or full. So here I am selecting full. After that press enter. We can see here we don't need to give the steps, it is counting automatically and the motor is also running. Next we will see the operation of bipolar stepper motor. So for this, connect CKE with clock, that is step input S1 to S0 and S2 to S1. Now connect the driver output to motor input, that is A1 to 1, B1 to 3 and B2 to 4, sorry, A2 to 4 and B2 to 6. Now turn on. The key. So select auto, the motor is started running. With the help of this potentiometer, we can vary the speed of the motor, and with the help of this we can select the direction. We can select the direction with the help of this. This is moving in anti-clockwise direction and this is moving in clockwise direction. Similarly, we can interface this microcontroller with the bipolar stepper motor, and we can also use this bipolar, control this bipolar stepper motor with this section like we did in unipolar motor. Now our next experiment is to see the servo motor. So we will connect the I2 test point here to servo motor. Now turn on the kit. We will select the motor. So this is servo motor. So select servo motor. After that we will see select mode. So select MCU51 mode. Now we can see the motor is moving as per the angle. This is now 0 degree, this is minus 45 degree, this is minus 90 degree, again minus 45 degree. Also with the help of an oscilloscope, here you can see the different types of pulse at 45 degree, 95 degree, minus 45 degree and minus 95 degree. Our next experiment is DC motor operating principle in discrete mode. So for this, connect CKE to clock, DC direction, M1 to M+, and m2 to m minus. After that, turn on the key. Now select this switch to turn on or off the motor. The motor is running. With the help of this knob, we can select the speed of the motor. Now with the help of this switch, we can select the motor direction. This is anti-clockwise and this is clockwise. Our next experiment is DC motor operating principle in microcontroller mode. So for this, connect I2 to clock, I1 to direction, M1 to M minus, and M2 to M plus. Now connect the trainer key. We can see that the motor is started running. It's DC motor. Select the mode. Now we need to give direction. We can select it at clockwise position or we can select it at anti-clockwise position. Like this.